Hey guys, welcome back to Triple L Rustic Designs. First of all, I want to say thank you so much for helping us grow our channel. We're at over 20,000 subscribers. And today, in this video, we're going to be mailing our first cherry log. Check it out. All right, so this log is about 10 feet long, and down here at the butt end, we got about 21 and a half inches. And down here on the skinny end, we're looking at 20 inches. So it doesn't really have that much of a taper, which is good. Now we're gonna get the log up on the mill and figure out what we're doing with it. Cherry log on the mill ever, I think we're going to cut it into some 2.5-inch slabs that can be made into tabletops. Real quick, I want to thank Barking Up the Right Tree Service. They're the ones that actually provide us with this cherry log. If you're in the Central Florida area looking for some tree service, I highly recommend them. I'll put all their contact information in the description below. cherry log up. You can see it has this really nice dark red color that resembles a cedar from last time. We're going to drop the mill down 2.5 inches and make our next cut. Lift the slab by myself, so I'm gonna call in some cheap labor to get the slab off the mill. Beautiful log I think we've cut yet. Look at that. That's beautiful. So much detail in the wood. These are gonna make some really beautiful tabletops. Blade's doing a really nice job cutting straight through this cherry, so we're gonna drop it down another 2.5 inches and cut another slab. Lot better than the oak we're usually cutting, so I'm gonna call in my guys and get the slab off the mill.
Wow.
We have a here, but we still have a lot of really nice material to work with. So I'm noticing more soft spots in the slab. It probably has something to do with the rot down here in the middle of the log. That's okay. We just recently partnered with an epoxy company, so we'll be able to fill all these voids with epoxy. That last cut was at 13.5 inches. We're gonna drop it down another 2.5, and we should be able to get another at least 5 slabs out of that. Hope this next slab isn't ruined by the rotten area, but we'll see. Dang, I knew this was gonna happen. We got a lot of rot in the middle here, but we'll be able to fix that with epoxy. So we'll be dropping this down another 2.5 inches. And at that point, it looks like I'll pretty much be in the center of the log. I'm a little worried about this rot here, and hopefully the slab stays together. But if not, it'll make a really nice river table. I just realized the log clamps are gonna get in the way of the blade. So we're gonna go ahead and flip the log over and then cut from there. I think I may be able to manage this piece on my own. Get a full thick slab off of this, so I'm just going to drop it down another inch and get a small slab. I think that 1-inch slab worked. Drop it down another 2.5 and continue our slab. Knot in the wood right there, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to pick this one up, so I'm gonna call in my reinforcement. There really isn't a lot of rot in this slab, so I'm gonna toss some water on it and show you guys its true color. Now that's some sweet, sweet cherry. Take a look. So that final cut was at 6.5 inches. We're gonna drop it down to another 2.5 and do one more thick slab. And then the final slab, we're gonna cut it into 2 2-inch slabs. Rot in this slab, we're going to keep it at 4 inches, and later down the road we can cut it in half to make 2 really nice cherry mantles. Alright guys, that does it for this video. These cherry slabs turned out absolutely beautiful. They're gonna make amazing tabletops. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. It really helps out our channel. And don't forget to subscribe for future videos. Also, drop a comment below. I want to see what kind of log you want me to cut next. See you next time.